intro, you know, welcome back to another video. It's been a while since we last recorded a video, but we're back. All well and all good. I'm in really good form, you know. Hope now getting into the sort of end of the year, sort of the Christmas time, you could say. And, you know, Thanksgiving's coming up, and many other sort of festive holidays as well. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day too. So let's dive into it, shall we, with this weekend's matches. I'm going to start off with the London Derby between Spurs and Chelsea. Now these two teams do not like each other, and Spurs have sort of been stuck in two places, you could say. Their legs are like a mirror image, but a double ganger mirror image.
What the fuck are you talking about?
You could say they're very good in the Premier League, but in the Champions League they've really struggled. And they've got two massive games this week, if you want to know the thing is. We got to Chelsea in a while. You know, they're playing to Milan in the Champions League this week. Whose game is that? They win that game, they're obviously back in the hunt, get out of the group. If they lose that game, they are out of it completely. But going back to the Chelsea game, you know, this is a huge game for them, for their aspirations of finishing the top four. Maybe an outside chance of actually fighting for the title, which I don't think they do, because they didn't spend in terms of squad. They've got nobody in the transfer window, the first team ever do that in transfer window history. And it's really affected their squad, because it affected their team, because like Eriksen has been out injured, Dele Alli has been out injured, Harry Kane hasn't really been Harry Kane scoring goals. Yes, I know he scored a big goal for England to get them into the Nations League finals next summer, but he hasn't really been the Harry Kane of old. You could say playing a lot of matches, didn't really have sort of a pre-season, and definitely didn't have sort of a break, which probably affected them. So, but they've got major injuries, and they're relying on the likes of Sissoko and the likes of many others that are just not good enough for top Hotspur at this moment in time. So, as for Chelsea, they're absolutely flying at the minute. The best start they've ever made to a Premier League season since they won the league under Mourinho's first season at Chelsea in 2003-2004 season. And notice a different Chelsea team. They're playing way much fancier football. Hazard's been sensational at the start of the season. You've also got Morata, who's now scoring goals now. Giroud is offering something as well. You've also got the likes of Jorginho and Kante, which is my favourite duo to watch in that midfield. What a midfield duo they've been this season so far. So they've had a really good blend. And I thought being in the Europa League would be a massive hindrance for them this season, because they're playing Thursday, Sunday, which we all know never works for any team that wants to be challenging for a title, challenging for top four places. Ask Manchester United, even ask Arsenal. So it's always been an hindrance, but to be honest, they've done very well. They have a fantastic squad. Ross Barkley is playing sensational football. He's now back in the England squad, doing really well for England. He's playing, I don't know about Sarri's making him a better player in terms of his distribution and his mental focus this season. Is second to none, unlike probably Everton and even under Antonio Conte's last sort of matches when he was manager of Chelsea last season. But for this game, I think it'll be a very high scoring match, but I think it will be a draw. I'm going 2-2. Now we're heading to Spain, and it's the massive game there this week, which is Atletico Madrid versus Barcelona, two of the three top three teams in Spain right now. Sevilla are actually second in the league at the moment. They're doing really well, but Barcelona top the league just for now, a point ahead of Sevilla, and 2 points ahead of Atletico Madrid. Atletico Madrid are playing this weekend. Atletico Madrid haven't really been the Atletico Madrid of old for me. They've always sort of, they're stumbling on the line. They're like a sprinter who is somehow pulled a hamstring. It's just getting to the end, just waiting for the flag to drop. So to be honest, I'm really surprised the way I mean, Madrid have spent a ton of money. Diego Costa hasn't scored a bloody league goal this season.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Wow, that's something. You've also got Griezmann, who they're relying so much on him. They've brought some other good players as well, like Thomas Müller, like I said. But Atletico Madrid, they just look disillusioned with them. They look like they're in a time lapse and they don't know what's going on. Now maybe they need to go back to the old Atletico Madrid, but just play 4-4-2, be solid at the back maybe. But again, I don't know, maybe Diego Simeone is chopping and changing systems, but it doesn't feel like the Atletico Madrid that won the league a couple of seasons back. As Barcelona, they lost their last game in the league against Real Betis in a cracking 4-2 win for Real Betis. But Barcelona's defensively were absolutely over the place. And I thought Barcelona, when they bought in Sevilla's Leganet, the French centre back, I thought he was going to step up and look to be a really good player. But again, it just looks like he's another ball passing centre back and not an actual defender. Pique, we all know, is coming sort of to the end of his career as a defender. So we'll wait and see on that. Tessegna had a fantastic season. He made some absolute saves, massive saves in that game against Real Betis to keep the score actually to keep the score line 4-3. It could have been 6 or 7 to be honest for Real Betis. But for me, this game, I think both them have a very good home record. Barcelona don't have a great away record, and I don't think they've actually beaten Atletico Madrid at the Atletico Madrid for quite a while. So I had to go for a 1-1 draw. Messi's back after his arm injury. I think he'll get a goal. I also think Diego Costa, he will break his duck and score his first La Liga goal this season. Now, incidentally, I'm talking about two teams that are definitely fighting for top four this season in Lazio and AC Milan. Now, these two have had compelling starts. AC Milan had a shocking start to their season where they only won one out of their first 5 matches. There's a lot of pressure on Gattuso. Is he the right man from AC Milan? And then they put some form up in Higuain, under Higuain and the new Italian striker right now, but he's talking about the young Crotone, I think his name is. They have a really good partnership with scoring goals and really look like, and Italy look like they finally have a goal scorer at the minute. You can put the ball in it for the Italian team. So he looks a real prospect for the future for AC Milan and Italy. But we're waiting to see him, and I'm still not feeling their midfield at the minute. AC Milan, I still think at times they have they can be a little bit all over the place. Kessie, is he really going to be the guy for them? Really? But they have a major injuries as well at AC Milan, like likes of Bonaventura is now out for probably the whole season, to be honest. He has a massive injury he got on international duty. So they're in a barrel of strengths, and they're really on the. There's so many players on the injury list, it's ridiculous. So wait and see other players step up and sort of step in their shoes and go and do it. As for Lazio, they've also had a very tricky start. First two matches were against Napoli and Juventus. Good enough for the two worst matches, if you say. The thing is, the runners-up and the champions for the last 7 years. So, to be honest, Lazio, they have a very good striker, Immobile, but I think Immobile at the minute, scoring goals for Lazio, scoring so many goals for Lazio. Why can he not do it for the Italian team? Why can he not do it for the jury? I don't know. Yeah, it's almost like it's a hindrance for the guy when he wears that blue shirt. He doesn't an Italian badge and sings the national anthem. He doesn't look like he's having fun when he's playing for Italy, which is really surprising because I think he's a very good striker. Probably could say he doesn't have the him and Insigne don't really work as a partnership up front, but we'll wait and see on that. But he's a very good striker, Mobley. He's definitely in the running for the Capo Campanaria this season for the Golden Boots. So for this, but then you also got Savage, who's a very good player. And they got other players like Luis Alberto and many other, and even former Global player and Lucas. So they have a very good team. They've also brought in Carrera from Sevilla in the summer. So they've got a good team. Do I think they're going to be challengers for the title? No. Them and AC Milan. And probably Roma are going to be fading out, probably going to finish in the top four. I think the other three pick itself, to be honest. So at this minute, I'm just sneaking for a Lazio win, but this could easily be a draw. But I'm just going for a Lazio win. I just think they have enough quality in the final third just to pick AC Milan off. We're actually struggling with major injuries at the minute. And for me, defensively, you can get at them. And the Germany, and probably the only big game this weekend, is Schalke versus Nuremberg. Two teams that are struggling in the Bundesliga right now. A massive 6-pointer for Schalke. I never thought I'd say that. This is a team that finished second in the league last season. They finished runners-up to Bayern Munich. Finished above the Red Bulls Borussia Dortmund. Finished above RB Leipzig. Finished above Hoffenheim. Finished above many top teams. And they're struggling in, I think they're 17th or 16th or 15th in the league. Somewhere around there. And Nuremberg are just promoted to the Bundesliga. They're also struggling, and I mean, a very major problem is they're struggling for goals. They're very good organized, they can keep a team defensively, they can't score goals, and for me, for a team, especially if you're promoted, if you don't have a goal scorer, I can score you 10 to 15 goals a season to get you out of the relegation sort of fight. you're going to be in it for the whole season. It's going to be a long season for them. Schalke have enough going forward. They've also getting their best players back, like Colin Blanca, and many other players coming back from major injuries. I just think they have enough going forward to just beat Nuremberg, and I'm going for a 3-1 win. Now we head back to the Premier League, and I'm talking about Fulham against Southampton. Fulham have sacked their manager, the first in the Premier League to sack their manager. Zvezdan Jokanović has been given the boot back to Serbia and probably looking for another job. They brought in back the old godfather himself and Claudio Ranieri, who did an amazing job of winning Leicester City the Premier League. Can he win Fulham the Premier League? They're 750,000 at the minute.
Hello?
That's not funny!
No, they can't. But it's a great story, the fact that he came back to the Premier League, came back to Fulham. Fulham at the minute are rock bottom of the Premier League. 5 points from their first 12 matches. Major, major problems with their team in terms of defensively, chop and change in the back four, chop and change in the system, from three at the back to five at the back to four at the back. I don't know what system are they playing. They keep changing the goalkeeper, which I also don't think helps the back four in terms of calmness and in terms of organisation. But I think Claudio Ranieri will get them stabilised.
You got a lot of problems, don't you?
Stability and organisation in that team. So they are hard to beat, like Leicester were when they won the league. And I think they've got very good players. They've got Mitrovic, who's a very good goalie. He will score goals. He scored 5 goals this season. He will get over 10 goals this season, maybe 12, which I think is enough for in terms of scoring goals. Their problem is defensively. Can't Manuel Ranieri get that defence sorted in time? Because at the minute, the gap is getting bigger. And with other teams picking points up in the bottom half of that table, it's going to be difficult. But there's a long way to go. We've seen last season with Roy Hodgson, who came into Crystal Palace, and we all thought they were down after 4 matches. No goals scored, relying on Wilfried Zaha. He did a remarkable game and finished 11th. So I don't think it's all doom and gloom in the minute for Fulham. I think it was the right decision. Probably you could say you should give him a season. You shouldn't give your kiss to your candidates a season. You just got them promoted. But again, the Premier League, if you're rock bottom after 12 matches, you'd be shocked if you even get to see another game. So it probably was the right decision, especially bringing an experienced coach in Claudio Ranieri. And I can see Fulham definitely staying up now because they've got a really good manager. They are definitely going to, they've got goals in their team for, they're going to score goals, but defensively it's been a major problem. So as for Southampton, they are even worse form than what Fulham are at the minute, because Southampton can't buy a goal. Like, that's been their problem all season. It's scoring goals. And yes, they were totally robbed at the end at the game against Watford. First point was Watford had a penalty, the most blatant penalty you see. But Charlie Austin, he inflated and blated about VAR. We are going to get VAR in the Premier League next season, which I've been crying for you. I've been crying for VAR since freaking the start of last season. But no, they would probably say, give it a season. We saw the World Cup works. It works in the Bundesliga, La Liga, Serie A. Every other top league has it, apart from the Premier League. So we now got VAR in the Premier League, which is going to be next season. So Charlie Austin's outburst definitely worked. But like I said, Southampton, they can't score goals. They're relying so much on Danny Ings. Danny Ings, he doesn't want to over risk in terms of a tackle, because he may get injured. And Charlie Austin, again, doesn't want to over risk because the man has got so many injuries over his career. So it's going to be a long season for Southampton. As for this game, I think Fulham will beat Southampton. I think Southampton don't have a good away record. Fulham have a very good home record. They beat Burnley there in their only win this season. Their home form is going to be vital for them to stay in the Premier League. And I'm going for a 1-0 win. I think Mitrovic will get the win. Now we're into France, and we're talking about Lyon against Saint-Étienne. Both teams are only a point. Saint-Étienne is only a point behind Lyon, and Lyon are only a point ahead of Saint-Étienne. These two teams are sort of 4th and 5th respectively. Saint-Étienne had a fantastic season. They definitely, that only last season, they were fighting for relegation. They were struggling. They had a manager who just didn't understand. It just didn't work, to be honest. So they've got a new manager now. They've got some really good players. They've got the likes of Remy Cabella, a permanent signing. They've also got the likes of Kazri, who we all know is a fantastic goal in terms of he can score a goal from nothing, from nowhere. We saw at the World Cup before Tunisia. So he's a very good player, and he's definitely been their best player in the season for Saint-Étienne, scoring goals, some cracking goals as well. And Leon relies so much on Fekir and Memphis Depay, but Dembele, who is a former Celtic striker, he's been scoring goals, even though I think he sort of needs a little bit of composure in the box, which I think his biggest problem is. He's very two-footed, but he needs to just compose himself and just slot the ball in there. Simple. And Fekir has been, I'm a massive fan of his. He's just an absolute baller. One of the best French players I think we're going to see in the future. You've also got Memphis Depay. He's on an absolute high after scoring an absolutely pinker penalty against France. An absolutely fantastic. And then also Dutch, who are in the finals of the Nations League, and they're a really good team of Van Dijk and Memphis Depay. You've also got Wijnaldum. You've got many good youngsters coming through the Dutch. Dutch are a really nice purple patch with their team. But for this game, I'm going for Leon to win this game 2-0. Now I'm back to Spain. I'm talking about Villarreal versus Real Betis. Real Betis on a massive high after beating Barcelona before the international break. And they, you probably are the favourites to win this game. They're definitely a squad. They have a very good squad. And they should be doing better than what their position is at the minute. Villarreal are struggling big time. And which is surprising me because Villarreal, I know they're the goal scorer. And so their main striker, which is now in the Chinese Super League. With speculation he might actually be back there on loan, maybe in the giant transfer window, but I don't know what to make of the whole thing for Villarreal. They got Santi Cazorla back as a massive experienced midfielder in there, but again, it doesn't. He's playing as sort of a free and the defence one, that doesn't work for me. So we wait and see what Villarreal can do. Massive pressure on the manager. As for Real Betis, I think they'll win this game by all goal. I think it'll be a 2-1 win. And Real Betis look a really good team this season. Keep your eye on them. Now to take the last game to talk about is Panama versus Sassuolo. These two are also sort of fighting for who's going to finish probably best of the rest of Serie A this year. You've got top six. You've probably got Fiorentina probably in there too. So Panama and Sassuolo have had excellent starts. Panama are newly promoted back from Serie A after their terrible, terrible decline with the administration and many other problems they had off field and even on field as well. So they had to go through the whole thing. They had to go from Serie D, Serie C, Serie B, and now they're back in Serie A, which is great to see Panama because they're a massive club. I remember Panama when Gianni Buffon was playing for them, and there was a world record fee. They're a very, very, very good, solid football club, and really, it's great to see them back and doing well in Serie A. So Sassuolo have a fantastic turn as well, and they sacked their manager last season. And, you know, relegated. They have a new manager, new philosophy, new players, and they look a really good team this year. But can they beat the Parma side that right now really look like to be the new Wolves in sort of in Serie A? And I don't think so. I just think Parma have enough quality, like Jorginho and many other players. So I just think Parma will win this game. So guys, there's the prediction for this episode. Don't forget, Total Impact will be back on Monday, so be watching that, be looking out for that. And yeah, hope you all guys are having a sensational day. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget clicking those notification bell to know when my other videos are up on the channel. Anyway, that's pretty much all I need to say. Hope you guys are all having a fabulous day. Say no to drugs, take care of yourselves, please like, subscribe, the natural is out.